Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and I wanted to talk to you about how to create Google Colab Notebooks for data science projects, how to use the best features that are in Colab Notebooks, and then how to share that with other people and really get the most use out of the Colab environment. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. Let's dive into how to use Google Colab Notebooks for data science projects, portfolio projects. You can see here, this is the default screen, and it gives you a good set of instructions for how to use it, worth taking a look at. The first thing I'm gonna do though is show you how to create a new Colab notebook. So we'll say file, new notebook. It goes ahead and it creates an empty blank template. A couple things to point out here is that you can name this something. So I'll go ahead and call this data science. And then what's nice about this naming structure is that it can be very related to a project that you're working on, and you can name it in a way that other people understand what this notebook's about. The other thing to point out is under runtime here, you can actually change your runtime so you can use GPUs. If you have the pro version, you get more high performance GPUs. You can also use TPUs as well. So there's a lot to like about both the pro and the regular environment. And it really can be helpful in using this as a hosted runtime. The other thing that I'll point out that I recommend to students in particular or data science professionals is to create a hierarchy in your project. So what I like to do is go here and say ingest as my first phase, and then I have another cell down here and I say EDA, and then I have another cell below called modeling, like this, and then I have the conclusion. And the idea here is that by creating a hierarchy, it's very easy for someone to understand what's going on in your project, and they don't have to navigate through thousands of lines of code. So notice as well how things get collapsed. And so I would recommend if you're a data scientist or a student doing data science, you have the structure, ingest, EDA, modeling, conclusion. Notice if I go on the left here, I can actually navigate through the table of contents. So really incredibly useful style here for sharing projects. Now, how would I actually go through and build out some code? Fortunately, you can just execute Python code. And for example, I can type in import pandas as PD, right? And import some project, import a library. Everything inside of this ingestion phase can be hidden or exposed depending on what I'm trying to do with it. The other thing I'll mention is that if you want to go ahead and save this or share it with someone else, there's a couple ways to do this. The easiest way by far would be to go file and say save a copy in GitHub. This is something I like to do quite a bit. And how would we actually arrange this? Easy way to do this would be to go to GitHub, create a new repository for some portfolio project you're working on. We'll just call this data science portfolio. And inside of here, I'll just make a README file and then create a repo. And now it's ready for me to do something with the Colab environment. All right, how would we save this to GitHub? I would go through here and go down to the name of the repo that I just created. In this case, this would be data science portfolio, and go ahead and say okay. This is a great way to share things with other people on your teams or in your company or with just a future employer, because it has this open in Colab link here, and then someone can just execute your code. One other way that is actually pretty powerful is that you also can use the features of the Google Drive environment. And in fact, how could you do this? Well, we could click on this share icon over here. And when you go to share, you could actually change to anyone on the internet with a link. And I could copy this link. And then I could also go down here and I could actually put in my README file, something like, open my notebook. And this is something that I think is very critical as well. If you have a huge notebook that maybe you want to do a demo on or code along with somebody, you can actually use the default Google Drive sharing capabilities. And what's awesome about this is that anybody has access to this without having to authenticate. So I would recommend if you are going to share, you know, either use one or both of these approaches to share your notebooks. The final thing I'll mention is here's a look at a more sophisticated project here that has, I would say, more of a traditional data science workflow. Let me go ahead and click on this Open in Collab link. And if I go to this Open in Collab link, notice that I can easily navigate this project. So I can look at ingest, EDA, modeling, inclusion. Notice in the ingest, I actually read through and I have a New York Times CSV file, and I use that for the rest of my project. One thing that's nice about this approach is I don't have to worry about data. And this is another highly recommended way to use Collab Notebooks is to be very critical about making it 100% reproducible and easy to navigate. So in a nutshell, those are some of the high-level features that I would recommend if you are dealing with data science with Collab as a student, a data science professional, or anyone else that wants to share and go ahead and get started on your own.